Good afternoon, students. It's 12 o'clock. Let us start next lecture of Math F212 Optimization. Audibility is okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for reply. So last time we were doing formulation for multivariable, or you can say more than two variables. So last question in that series. In an LTL less than truck load trucking company, terminal docks include casual workers who are hired temporarily to account for peak loads. So you have to hire some workers, right, for loading and unloading at the Omaha Nebraska dock. The minimum demand for the casual workers during 7 days of the week starting on Monday is 20, means you require the 20 casual worker on 14 on Tuesday, 10 on Wednesday, 15 on Thursday, 18 on Friday, 10 on Saturday and 12 on Sunday. Each worker is contracted to work 5 consecutive days. If any worker is joining on Monday, then he will work for the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. If someone is joining on Tuesday, then he will work for Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So 5 consecutive days. Determine an optimal weekly hiring practice of casual workers for the company. So on what day, how many worker we should appoint, right? We should appoint in our company. So let us assume a random variable, decision variable xi, number of casuals worker starting on day I. So I is equal to 1 represent the Monday, I is equal to 2 represent Tuesday, I is equal to 3 is equal to Wednesday, similarly I is equal to 7 for the Sunday. And we want number of worker, casual workers should be minimum, because we have to give the wages. So the number of worker in a week should be minimum. So minimize z is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus x5 plus x6 plus x7. Means that will give you the total number of worker in a week, and that count should be minimum. Now if any worker is joining on Monday, so he will work for Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. If worker is joining on Tuesday, then he will work up to the Saturday. If worker is joining on Wednesday, then he will work up to the Sunday. If worker is joining on Thursday, so Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday and then Monday, he continue up to the Monday. Similarly, if one is joining on the Friday, then he will work for Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday and Tuesday. Similarly, if anyone is joining on Sunday, then he will work for Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday. And on Monday you require at least 20 casual workers, on Tuesday you require 14 casual workers, similarly on Sunday you require 12 casual workers. So here the problem will become minimize of x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus x5 plus x6 plus x7 subject to constraint. So here it will become x1 plus x4 I was saying that problem will be the minimize x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus x5 plus x6 plus x7 subject to constraint x1 plus x4 plus x5 x1 plus x4 plus x5 plus x6 plus x7 greater than equal to 20. Similarly, x2 plus x5 plus x6 plus x7 plus x1 greater than equal to 14 and so here we have the x3 plus x4 plus x5 plus x7 x6 plus x7 greater than equal to 12 and x1 comma x2 comma x7 greater than equal to 0. So non-negativity condition, it is necessary to write in the LP problem because number of the workers on any day cannot be negative. Either it can be the 0 or positive. So non-negativity restriction will come here. So when we solve, so for a week, you have to hire 20 casual workers. Means on the first day, on the first day 8, then on the second day, you have to hire on the fourth day, means 6, and then x5 is equal to 4, x6 is equal to 1, and x7 is equal to 1. So here we have the 8, here we have the 6, then 4, then 1, then 1. So you can check, here we have the 8 plus 6, 14 plus 4, 14 plus 4, 18, 18 plus 1, 19 and 1, 20. So it is the greater than equal to 20. Then the this one, so it is the 8 plus 4, 12 plus 1, 13 plus 1, 14. Then here we have the 1 plus 1, 2, then plus 8, that is the 10. Then here we have the 15, so 8 plus 6, 14 plus 1, 15. So you can check this solution is the optimal solution and it satisfies all the constraints. So in this way, so you have seen the various example, manufacturing, production, blending, scheduling, right? Division of the time, division of the labor, all these type of the example you have seen. So in this way you can formulate. Any doubt in the formulation? So from my side, formulation is over. Anybody, any doubt? So now let us move to now analytical method for solving the linear program, algebraic method for solving the linear program. So we have seen at the when I have taught you the graphical solution, at the time I have told you that this will be the basic, means this will be the platform where we try to understand how to determine the solution. So whatever we have done in the graphical solution, the same thing we will do here, same thing we will repeat here, but algebraically. So LP model in equation form. So first we have to write our LP model, linear programming model, in an equation form. So there also, for making the graph, we have to make the first line, and line is what? The equation, right? First we have to convert our inequality into the equation. There also, in the graphical solution also, we have converted. So what is the condition? So it is the it is the there are the two conditions. There are two conditions. All the constraints, please see, please listen carefully. Very important thing is coming. All the constraints, with exception of non-negativity of the variable. Just we will not change the non-negative restriction into the equation. Otherwise, all the constraints other than non-negative restriction are equation with non-negative right hand side. Means all the constraints should be of equal to with non-negative right hand side. With non-negative right hand side. And the all variable must be non-negative. Means all variable must be non-negative. So these two conditions we have to take care for writing the LP problem in the equation form. So we have the two type of the inequality. Either we have the less than inequality or greater than inequality. So here we have the less than something. So what is this in the formulation? This is the maximum availability of the resources. This is maximum availability of the resource. Maximum availability of the resource. And what is this? This is the usage of the resource by an activity. So for example, if you recall the first constraint of the ready mix, it is the 6x1 plus 4x2 less than equal to 24. So what is this? This is the maximum availability of the material M1. And what is this? This is the usage of the material by the activities, by the different activities. What are the different activities? Production of the exterior paint and production of the interior paint. So these are the activity by which we are utilizing the material M1. So in this case, when we have the less than equal to means either we will utilize the constraint, utilize the material, utilize the resource lesser than the available one or up to the available quantity. So if you compute the difference 24 minus 6x1 plus 4x2, so what is this? This is the unused amount. If you compute this, so this is the unused amount, or you can say slack amount. So it means if they have the equation, so in this case, if you add that slack amount, so that will become the equation. So here it is written, in less than equal to constraint, the right hand side can be thought as representing the limit on the availability of the resource, in which case the left hand side would represent the usage of this limited resource by the activities variable, right, of the model. The difference between right hand side and the left hand side of the less than equality constraint thus yields the unused or slack amount of the resource. So to convert the less than inequality to an equation, a non-negative, main thing is all variable must be non-negative. So non-negative slack variable is added. So we have to add the non-negative slack variable. Similarly, when we have the greater than equal to, so greater than equal to means some constraint, then greater than equal to. So you have to use, right? It means the left hand side are greater than equal to right hand side. So when we compute the left minus right, if you compute the left minus right, so it will give you the surplus amount. So if you want to convert this into the is equal to form, so here you have to subtract the surplus variable. So when you subtract the surplus variable from the greater than inequality constraint, so you will get the equation form. So next, a greater than equal to constraint sets the lower limit on the activities of the LP model. So this is the lower limit. You have to utilize more than this. more than this, right? You have to reply more than this. So that amount by which left hand side exceeds the minimum limit represent the surplus. The conversion from greater than equal to the is equal to is achieved by subtracting a non-negative surplus variable from the left hand side of the inequality. Means if we have 6x1 plus 4x2 less than equal to 24. So here we have the less than equal to. So in this case we will add 4x2 plus s1 is equal to 24. So here we will add the slack variable. Here we add the slack variable to make it in the equation form. If we have 6x1 plus 4x2 greater than equal to 24, then to make it in the equation form, 6x1 plus 4x2 minus s2 is equal to 24. So here we subtract the surplus variable. So in this way we make the less than is equal to or greater than equal to into the is equal to form. Now let us have some small example. Consider the following inequality: 10x1 minus 3x2 greater than equal to minus 5. So that by multiplying both side of inequality by minus 1, then converting the resulting inequality into the equation is the same as converting it first to an equation, then multiplying both side by the minus 1. So here we have the 10x1 minus 3x2. Here we have 10x1 minus 3x2 greater 10x1 minus 3x2 greater than equal to minus 5. So if it is the greater than, so we can say first we subtract the surplus variable. So minus s1 is equal to minus 5. Now when we multiply with the minus 1, so right, subtract the surplus variable, then multiply with the minus 1. Multiply with the minus 1, so it will become minus 10x1 plus 3x2 plus s1 is equal to 5. So what I have told you, always we have to write in the equation form in such a way the right hand side should be non-negative. In the first condition I have given you, right, right hand side should be non-negative. Here if you multiply first by the minus 1, it will become the minus 10x1 plus 3x2, and the sign of inequality will change and it will become the 5. Then to convert into the equation form, here we have to 10x1 plus 3x2 plus s2 is equal to 5. So we have to add the slack variable. So adding of the slack variable. So you can compare both equation are the same. So it's up to you how you are making the equation with non-negative right hand side. That is the practice question only. So it is up to you how you are making your equation with the non-negative right hand side. In the very first slide I have given you this point that we have the equation with the non-negative right hand side. Now two different products P1 and P2 can be manufactured by one or both of two different machines M1 and M2. So here we have the production system. We are producing the two products P1 and P2 via the machine M1 and M2. The unit processing time of either product on either machine is same. The daily capacity of the machine M1 is 200 units of either P1 or P2 or a mixture of both. So daily capacity of the machine M1, either you produce only product 1, only product 2, a mixture of 2, maximum you can produce 200 products. And the daily capacity of the machine M2 is 250 units. The shop supervisor wants to balance the production schedule of the two machines such that total number of units product on one machine is within the 5 unit of the number of number produced on other. Means the difference between the product, difference between the production on machine 1 and machine 2 or machine 2 machine 1 cannot be more than 5. It should be less than 5, right? Either the production through machine 1 minus production through machine 2 should be less than 5. Similarly, from the machine 2 minus from the machine 1, it should be less than 5. The profit per unit of P1 is $10 and debt of the P2 is $15. Set up the problem as NLP in equation form. So first we have to formulate the problem, then we have to write in the equation form. Right? At last you have to write in the equation form. So what we assume? Xij. Xij represent number of units of the product I, P1 and P2, manufactured on the machine J. Machine J, that is the machine 1 and machine 2. So what can be the variable? X11, X12, X21, X22. And it is given to you the profit. The profit on product 1 is $10 and product 2 is the $15. So here, this is the product 1. Product 1 on machine 1, product 1 on machine 2. Into 10. So it is the total profit by the or profit by the product 1. Similarly, this is the product 2 on machine 1 and machine 2 respectively. So total profit by the product 2 will become 15 into X21 plus X22. So their addition will give you the total profit, and we have to, in the LP problem, we have to maximize the LP. So maximize Z is equal to this. Now subject 2. In the subject 2, later on I will come this part. Subject 2, at most machine 1 can produce the 200 item. So machine 1, either it is producing the product 1, product 2. So X11 plus X21 cannot be more than 200. So it can be only less than is equal to 200. Similarly, for the machine 2, maximum production can be 250. Either it produce the product 1 or product 2. So X12 plus X22 must be less than equal to 250. Then after, the production between these two, production by both machine cannot differ by the 5. Right? It should be less than 5. Cannot be more than by the 5. So it is the total production by the machine 1, either the product 1 or product 2, or it is the total production by the machine 2, either for the product 1 or product 2. Their differences, and when we take the absolute value, so either you take the production of machine 1 minus production of machine 2, their differences cannot be more than the 5 units. All the numbers should be non-negative. So Xij greater than equal to 0. Clear? Now we have to write in the equation form. So when we write in the equation form, so what it can be written? Due to the mod, it can be written as X11 plus X21 minus X12 plus X22 less than equal to 5, and this greater than equal to minus 5. Right, due to the absolute value, due to the mod, this we can break into the two equation. Correct this one? Any doubt? correct this one. So from the first, let us have the first constraint, second constraint, third constraint, fourth constraint. So the first constraint will become x11 plus x21 minus x12 minus x22 plus s1 is equal to 5. So we have to add the slack variable. Then in the second constraint, first you multiply with the minus. So it will become minus x11 minus x21 plus x12 plus x22 plus s2 is equal to 5. Only main thing is right hand side should be non-negative. Then x12, then x11, x11 plus x21 plus x21 plus s3 is equal to 200. Then x12, x12 plus x22 plus s4 is equal to 250. And all the variable, so these slack variable are also non-negative. So all the variable means x11, x12, x21, x22, s1, s2, s3, s4 greater than so it should be greater than equal to 0, right? It should be greater than equal to 0. So that is the way to write the given problem into the equation. So here we have done the same thing. Right. So all the variable means decision variable as well as the slack surplus variable, all the variable must be non-negative. Here I have written, and all the right hand side should be non-negative. Then we have to convert into the equation form. Hopefully it is clear. Now in this question, so how the following objective function can be presented in equation form? Minimize z is equal to maximum of mod of x1 minus x2 plus 3x3 comma mod of minus x1 plus 3x2 minus x3. So let us assume, let y is equal to max of mod of this. So when I'm saying that y is the maximum of this, it means mod x1 minus x2 plus 3x3, this will be less than equal to y. This will be less than equal to y, because y is what? Maximum of these two. And mod minus of x1 plus 3x2 minus x3 less than equal to y. If y represent the maximum of these two, means both are less than equal to y. And it is, hint is given to you, if the mod of a less than equal to b, it is equivalent to a less than b and a greater than equal to minus b. So this can be written as x1 minus x2 plus 3x3 less than y and x1 minus x2 plus 3x3 greater than equal to minus y. Similarly, this can be written as minus x1 plus 3x2 minus x3 less than equal to y and minus x1 plus 3x2 minus x3 greater than equal to minus y. So now in the first one if you add the slack variable s1, in the second one if you subtract the surplus variable s2, in the third one if you add the slack variable s3, in the fourth one if you subtract the surplus variable s4, so it will become right, these will become the is equal to. Only the main thing is right hand side should be non-negative, right hand side should be in the non-negative. So due to the non-negative, if you take the minus y on this side, minus y plus x1 minus x2 plus 3x3 plus s1 is equal to 0, then it will become y plus x1 minus x2 plus 3x3 minus s2 is equal to 0, then minus y minus x1 plus 3x2 minus x3 plus s3 is equal to 0, and this will become y minus x1 plus 3x2 minus x3 plus minus s4 is equal to 0. So this is now the right hand side non-negative. All the variables y, x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, s3, s4, all the variables are on the left hand side, all the constant on the other side, and beside this we have to write y, x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, s3, s4, all are non-negative. So this is the way to write the equation in the standard form, in the standard equation form. So here they have added the slack variable, so with that here we have the change in the sign. Here they have added the slack variable, so here we have the change of the sign. So either you change the sign, or means up to you whether you are adding the slack variable or surplus variable. Only the main thing is right hand side should be the non-negative. Clear? Any doubt? Yes, anyone? Anything you? Now, so that the M equation, this is the M equation, means A11 x1 plus A12 x2 plus A1n xn is equal to B1. Similarly, here we have, what is the meaning of this line? This is the A11 x1 plus A12 x2 plus A1n xn is equal to B1. Similarly, AM1 x1 plus AM2 x2 plus AMN xn plus BM. So here we have the M equations with N variable, right? M equation with N variables. Are equivalent to following m plus 1 inequalities. These m equations can be written in the form of the m plus 1 inequalities. So you know the first equation, this equation can be written as you know the is equal to can be written as a11 x1 plus a12 x2 so on a1n xn less than equal to b1 and a11 x1 plus a12 x2 and so on a1n xn greater than equal to b1 is equal to can be written in these two inequalities form. So total we have the m less than inequalities, right? Total we have the m greater than inequality. So when we add these m in greater than inequality, so what will happen? What you will get? So if you add the all the left hand side bm, so left, the sum of the left hand side always greater than equal to sum of the right hand side. So that can be written as the sum of the left hand side, sum of the left hand side always greater than equal to sum of the right hand side, so total we have the m equation from here, and m plus 1th equation here. So total we have the m plus 1 equation means inequalities. If we have the m equations here, that can be written as a m plus 1 inequalities, where m inequalities are of less than type and m plus 1th inequality, one inequality of the greater than type. Now, dealing with the unrestricted variable. So it is very important. I have told you all the variable must be non-negative, must be greater than or equal to 0, must be non-negative. But when we have the unrestricted variable means it can be the negative, it can be 0, it can be positive. There is no restriction of the non-negativity. Then how we can deal? So next is the dealing with unrestricted variable. Means the variable can take any value, positive, zero or negative. To understand what is the meaning of the non-negativity, let us have this example. Mac Burger fast food restaurant sells the quarter pounder and cheeseburger. There are the two type of the burger, quarter pounder and the cheeseburger. The quarter pounder uses the quarter of pound of meat and cheeseburger uses 0.2 pound. So it uses the quarter of this means it uses the 0.25 of meat and cheeseburger use the 0.2 pound. The restaurant starts the day with 200 pound. The maximum availability of the meat is the 200 pound, but may order more at an additional cost of 25 cents. But if the demand is more than the 200 maximum resource, maximum availability, then he can purchase with the additional cost of the 25 cent per pound to cover the delivery cost. Any surplus meat at the end of the day is donated to charity. If the Mac Burger is not able to use complete 200 pound, if there is some remain, right, then he donated to the charity. Mac Burger profit 20 cents for quarter pounder and 15 cents for the cheeseburger. Mac Burger does not expect to sell more than 900 sandwiches in any one day. Maximum demand he is expecting as a 900 only. How many each sandwiches should the Mac Burger plan for a day? Solve using the Torah. That is another thing. So in this case, we have the two type of the burger. So let us assume for x1 and x2, number of quarter pounder and it is the for the cheeseburger. It is the quarter pounder and it is the cheeseburger. So what is given to you? First thing, the profit. Profit we have to maximize. So maximize z is equal to, please see very carefully, very important thing is coming.
20x1 plus 15x2, right? That is the maximized z is equal to 20x1 plus 15x2. Now, what is the limitation? Limitation is the both maximum sale up to the 900 only. It means x1 plus x2 less than equal to 900. X1 plus x2 is equal to less than equal to 900. More than this, he cannot sell. Then, what is the total availability of the meat? That is the 200. Maximum availability of the meat is the 200. And what is the utilization? 0.25 in the quarter pounder and 0.2 in the cheeseburger. Now please give the concentration. Now the whether this 200 is enough or not. If it is not enough, then he can purchase from the market, right, with the additional cost of the 25 cent per dollar. He can manage more. See, now please give me the answer. If 200 is enough, what we can add for making the equation? Anyone please answer.
Plus surplus S1.
I am saying that if 200 is enough, it means there is some extra amount. I am saying that there is some extra amount which he will donate to the charity. If 200 pound is not enough, he has to purchase from the market. So this is the amount for the charity, and this is the amount purchase from market. This is only the thing. Clear? Can both be
Sir,
the
can
positive
you please repeat this?
I am saying that this is the total uses. This is the availability, maximum availability. Maximum availability may be more than the total uses, right? So we have some unused meat. Let us say x3 minus. So unused meat. It is the unused meat, and for charity, he will donate to the charity. If 200 pound is not enough, usage is this utilization is more, demand is more than the 200, then he has to purchase from the market. So market means whatever the extra amount he has to purchase. Then this will be the whatever you are purchasing from the market, that you subtract from the utilization, then that will be equal to the 200 pound. So this is the amount purchased from market. So my question is, both x3 minus and x3 plus. My question is, x3 minus and x3 plus. These are the variable name. Need not to go with the minus and plus. Later on, I will tell you why I have written this. Can both be simultaneously non-negative? Can simultaneously positive?
No, sir.
Either we have the unused meat, or we have the over demand. Both cannot happen simultaneously. Means at a time, one is the positive, another one will be the zero. So if we have the this type of things we represent as a x3. And what is the x3? x3 is the x3 minus minus x3 plus, and this x3 is termed as a URS. This x3 is termed as a URS, means unrestricted in sign. Unrestricted in sign means it can be positive, it can be negative, it can be zero. And now, if you have to purchase from the market, what you have to do? You have to pay 25 cent, right? You have to pay the 25 cent. It means from the profit we have to subtract the 25 cent, whatever the amount you are purchasing. So now this is the profit function. Now this is the profit function. So this will be the correct formulation, and here the x3 is nothing, that is the unrestricted in sign. So in the unrestricted in sign you have seen x3 is urs, but x3 can be written as x3 minus minus x3 plus, right? Means I am saying that if we have the 5 can be written as 5 minus 0 minus 5, that is the 0 minus 5. So that is the unrestricted in sign. Or 0, it can be written as 5 minus 5. So it is the URS. This is the non-negative. Our first requirement is what? All the variable must be non-negative. So by chance, if variable is URS, you replace that variable, URS variable, unrestricted in sign variable. That is the requirement of the meet. In this question, requirement of the meet, that you have to replace by the two non-negative restriction, non-negative variable. Means here we have the x3 minus and x3 plus, both are non-negative. Clear? Still any doubt? So that is the question. So in this case, you can see we have the x3 plus is the positive, so automatically x3 minus is the zero.
Sir?
Yes.
The amount which is going for charity, from that also we are also not making profit.
नहीं तो वो तो प्रॉफिट कैसे होगा चैरिटी में? चैरिटी तो हम बेच थोड़ी रहे हैं. We are not
selling. Sir, we are calculating Z for 0.2x1 plus 0.15x2. So where we have included the condition that we are not making profit from charity.
अरे तो that is the plus zero x3 minus.
Okay.
We are not spending money, we are not getting any profit from the charity. Any other doubt? So main thing is all the variable x1, x2, x3 minus, x3 plus must be non-negative. Then only you can solve. So in next class we continue. Actually, this is the same kind of the thing. So it is good question. So in next class we continue. If you have any doubt till now, you can ask. This question we will continue in next class. So have a nice day.
Thank you, sir.